Happy late morning. Just sitting here, organizing my day. Got a little Coltrane playing. Excuse me, I'm sorry, not Coltrane, the Loneliest Monk. And Miles Davis. Then we're going to get into some content today, and I'm just kind of doing a live stream, an open house at my virtual office, which you can reach at edu.athearts.com or just athearts.com. You'll find the link near the top of both pages. So we'll be streaming for a few hours today. Got a couple things that I want to get done. Let's be more productive in the new year. We'll stream more and work more when we get more done. So that's what we're up to today. Well, thanks for jamming with me. We're going to wrap that here.
Talk about HTML today.
First of all, where's my plums?
I didn't go to the...
You were supposed to go to the store, get my plums, right. Bring them back, and you want me to talk...
Listen, but first I wanted to ask you...
I don't care about no HTM whatever, okay? Team, bring some plums, we're going to watch some old cartoons. Here we go.
Now this is what's happening. Talking about something else today.
I don't care. Next time, bring me my plums, and you have no problem. Every time I ask you to do something for me, you gotta get me to run around. You come back and ask me to do something.
Just ask Grandpa, I'll go get the plums, but if you can.
Not really. I don't care. Just watching. This is what we're doing.
I'll go get the plums, but if you can just first talk about the HTML.
Okay. Well, go back to the store, get some plums, then I'll talk about whatever you want me to talk about.
All right.
Okay.
Yeah, man. Sometimes a hyperlink is underlined.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
And undermined and unrefined. So mine. Yeah, when I see a hyperlink, I think. And I blink. Let's get it.
Hello, my name is Anthony Howard, owner of ATH Arts. I've worked as a creative professional for over 20 years, servicing a variety of companies and agencies. As a small business owner myself, one of the biggest things that bothers me is how hard it is for other small business owners to access high-quality professional design. The education, specialization, and difficulty involved in producing good design often requires several hours of work. Since most designers bill at an hourly rate, project budgets can often balloon out of control. Of course, there are many affordable online do-it-yourself options, but they don't help you with the most critical thing each new business needs, a cohesive and comprehensive marketing strategy paired with compelling design. Without a strategy, of how you want to communicate with your customers, the best design in the world won't win new ones. Our new Flex accounts are custom made for emerging entrepreneurs who seek high quality design, but at a rate they can afford while also having a design professional available to them along the way for feedback and advice. Our Flex accounts offer amazing benefits to new business owners. We offer subscription-based pricing. What that means is instead of paying the traditional 50% upfront cost for your project, we work with you to craft a monthly schedule. This allows you to take the time needed to complete your project carefully and comprehensively, and also manage project costs over the length of the project. We offer marketing strategy, consultation, and coaching. We work with you to craft a branding and marketing strategy to ensure that your project has the optimal chance for success. We'll set up a video meeting schedule with one of our creative professionals according to your schedule and availability. It's very important that we issue clear and simple proposals and contracts to ensure that there is no confusion about your project and how it will be implemented. You can visit ATH Arts to find out more about our Flex accounts. Thank you for considering ATH Arts for your project. Have an awesome and productive day.
It's your boy Greasy Mike, your favorite blogger, give you the latest internet tech news in some ratchet part of Oakland. First up, we have the new hot site, www.factsonrats.com, son. It's down, son. It got hacked, son. Allegedly, it got hacked by an individual named Cool Cat. If you've seen this individual, please report him to the authorities. Don't worry, son. I ain't no snitch. I ain't no snitch, Poppy. Ain't no snitch. I ain't gonna tell on you. I ain't gonna tell on you. You can tell on me. That's it. All right, come back to your boy, Greasy Mike. Coming back to you again with some latest internet tech news. Out. Oh, here we go. On a flow, let's take a show in. So let's go to www.gettickets2thetheater.com, and me and you, baby, we go for a night of magic. Yeah, just me and you, baby, watching Cats. Yeah.
ATH Arts Edu uses the latest digital tools to provide you with an interactive and immersive virtual learning experience. If you've ever played a video game, our virtual classrooms will be second nature to you. You can create your own unique avatar and join us in a metaverse space that's part Legend of Zelda and part Zoom. For more information about our virtual classrooms, visit edu.atharts.com.
Exactly what you think, take you from one site to another, my brother, that's an easy one, let's move on to another. Then you have the B-tag, coming through with the bold swag, coming through with the full max, use it for emphasis, yo, when you big mad. Then you got his homeboy strong, they do the same thing, that's why they get along. Then you got the body tag, don't use it, they put you in a body bag, yeah.
Well, that's it for our show. Thanks for stopping by. Come back soon for the next edition of Awesome Sauce. Apparently, Cool Cat had to leave in a hurry, but we'll address that later. Peace.
You got gotta make sure you use your brackets in this racket when you write your A tag. You link to another web page on the internet, the World Wide Web, whatever you want to call it. Yes. It's how you get from one web page to another, because it's a hyperlink. Hypertext. Hyperlink. Hypertext.
Dreams are the fuel for our reality. Dreams drive us to push past our limits. Dreams are the playground of artists, geniuses, and madmen. Dreams are a primal force that shoots us to the stars. But when it's all said and done, the world requires doers, building businesses, forging our narratives, creating our technology. Doers are not content with standing on the edge. They dive in, head first, into the unknown. Now, dreams are great, but when you are ready to do, call me. ATH Arts, dreaming of new ways to help you do you.
Welcome, sunny California. We have our number one spot for the week. In consecutive weeks, we have John Block with Super Cali. You know we play the hits, nothing but the hits. Let's go. Hey.
Super Cali Magic sipping purple power potion. Super Cali Magic sipping purple power potion. Super Cali Magic sipping purple power potion. Super Cali Magic, 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 magic. Super Cali Magic sipping purple power potion. Super Cali Magic sipping purple power potion. Super Cali Magic sipping purple power potion. Super Cali Magic, 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 magic.
Yeah, obliviate. Memories go away, breathing the air of a better day. Leaving the planet for about a day. Sky full of diamonds with Lucy. She can fly how she wants, she doing it just for the fun. She like to play in the sun, chasing it back with the rum. Notice she's sucking her thumb. She like to get in the mood. Bubblegum life, she a lot of youth. Smile cause she looking like fool. Haze in her eyes, a beautiful view. Bag, plus she like rolling a lot. Man, I'm all in the spot. She doing her thing, showing her thanks, flicking the big till the side.
Super Cali Magic sipping purple power potion. Super Cali Magic sipping purple power potion. Super Cali Magic sipping purple power potion. Super Cali Magic, 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 magic. Super Cali Magic sipping purple power potion. Super Cali Magic sipping purple power potion. Super Cali Magic sipping purple power potion. Super Cali Magic, 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 magic.
Yeah. Watch it all just right there, disappear. Call a plug up, magic, reappear. Lean your head back, way back, leave it there. Bend time every time that I lean stairs. When the smoke goes up, I put down my cell phone on my beard. Then I go right in the fridge. Purple, we quenching our thirst. She used to be a real nurse, so sick, my heart hurt. But it seems so perverse. Face down on the couch till her neck hurt. With a bad baby glad, cause she really love that. Going half on the meal, so I eat first. But I knew right then when I looked in, she flat on her back and she did me the sin. Shit, she started kissing her friend. And right at that moment, I knew that she wanted to win.
Super Cali Magic sipping purple power potion. Super Cali Magic sipping purple power potion. Super Cali Magic sipping purple power potion. Super Cali Magic, 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 magic. Super Cali Magic sipping purple power potion.
Hey, welcome, Bam Sir Abby. Appreciate it. Thanks for stopping by.
Hypertext markup language. 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 Yeah, baby.
Oh, yeah.
It's the language of the internet. Yeah, baby.
Hey, welcome to Rock the Block. I'm John Block, and we have a very special guest in the house tonight. We have AJ from Float. AJ, what's up, man? How you doing?
Hey, what's good? What's good? Yeah, I'm good, man. Thanks for having me. Good to be here.
We appreciate you being here. And I know, like, the Float team and your vision, you plan some really special things for creatives, utilizing technology and pushing things forward. So tell me exactly, what is Float?
Yeah, so, you know, Float is a music discovery platform really built for independent artists, powered by crypto. Maybe that's the easiest way to think about it. You know, we care about a couple of things. We care about independent artists, especially recording artists, who we know have very little options for, you know, how to monetize their work in the current environment. And we think blockchain solves a lot of their problems.
Just kind of getting my slow start
and
now.
We, you know, we know that this technology is not easy to understand.
Coffee and my 420
and,
goodness.
Yeah, there requires some onboarding. So, you know, our business, our platform that we're building content. Does two things. It helps us identify talented artists that we want to help elevate and we want to, you know, help amplify. And then the second part is an accelerator that allows us to onboard these artists and to get them more familiar with crypto and how to use these tools to build sustainable, sustainable careers for themselves.
Okay. So some of the things that you're describing, the idea of, you know, kind of helping support artists, education, reaching their audience and managing their career as a business. So it sounds like, does this work in tandem, you know, if an artist has an agent, you know, or is this like the new form of agency moving forward?
I think there's a lot of ways to for an artist to implement this into what they're already doing. Like, you know, we think that for at least the time being,
live streams,
there is a parallel system that is sort of put in place. You know, artists have their traditional music business, right? That includes, you know, Spotify and SoundCloud and Apple Music. They may be, you know, signed. They may have agent. They may have manager, etc. That infrastructure. What they probably don't have is someone who is very formidable on the tech side, right? And I think we think that that's a very important part of the infrastructure that every artist needs. And so whether you have all the other pieces, you know, this is a piece that's going to be required and can, you know, be integrated into everything else an artist does.
Oh, very cool. All right. And so that integration, is that thing simply like, you know, like an app, you know, in a sense where, you know, I can get stats and data and information? Is it a real-time agent waiting there to tweet with me and to message? How does that work?
Yeah, we'll see. I think, you know, what we are really doing is we're going to build right alongside the community. So we have an idea and a vision for what the initial product looks like. But over time, it's going to evolve a lot, right? You know, just given where we are in this space, where blockchain and crypto is relative to music, there's a lot of development that needs to happen. And we need to, you know, really be building with our community of users, right? So, you know, really what we're focusing on is bringing in and onboarding, you know, the most talented artists that we can find, whose creativity we will use, right, in order to, you know, start developing a product that, you know, they find useful and really helping them solve real life problems that they have. So, so TBD on what this looks like eventually, because I think it can go a lot of different directions. I have sort of a vision for what that could be, but really we want that vision, right, that's realized to come from the community of users that are using us. And then, you know, we think that's the best approach.
Oh, very cool. All right. So can you tell, you know, share some of the use cases with some of the artists that you've worked with, and like, what did that collaboration or project look like?
Yeah, sure. So we did, you know, we have a couple of things that are going on right now that are really interesting, more experiential. And we really like, you know, NFTs as tickets. You know, as I think about music and NFTs, I think there are sort of two categories. You know, you have the actual music and the songs and that experience, and then you have you know, other experiences that can be unlocked with the ownership of NFTs. So so when we think about, you know, how to work with artists and can take one of these two forms, what we've done, you know, to date, Billy Racks is probably the best example to use is, so Billy came to us, he had, you know, he's an independent artist, has been fiercely independent, he's been approached by labels, has maintained his independence and wants to kind of stay there on that side. And, you know, he had an album that was coming up that he wanted to release. He wanted to employ NFTs and crypto into that. And so we really helped him think about the story he was going to tell through not only this release of music, but subsequent releases, and how he could employ NFTs to bring his fans along that journey with him. So, what we built for him was a content machine that he can, anytime he releases music, he can put it on his own platform, essentially his own website, and we put a token gate on it. So in order to access that website and get the pre-release content or music, the owner or the fan would have to own the NFT in order to access it. So, you know, anytime now Billy wants to release music or videos or anything, he can, you know, mint an NFT, sell that NFT, and then require that anyone who wants to, you know, look and enjoy and consume that content early to be an owner of that NFT. And so it allows him to monetize his content in a way that wasn't, you know, what he wasn't able to before. And so we love that model. We think that was a proof of concept that was extremely, you know, well-informed and helped us, you know, learn a ton about how to communicate with the artists, how to instruct artists, communicate with fans, how to, you know, what sides of the crypto sphere, you know, NFT should be sort of positioned and bought, auction mechanics and design and all those things sort of came into play with that experiment. And yeah, it really helped accelerate a lot of what we're doing now.
So in short, you guys over at the team at Float is doing, you know, looking forward to the future, working with creatives and figuring out what's next and figuring out what kind of solutions and opportunities are available for creatives and how, so, and setting things up, working with them so they can best, you know, seize those opportunities,
right,
you know, and monetize them and extract the value from it.
Right.
So what should creatives be thinking about these days, right? So for those new creatives, they may not necessarily know about, you know, blockchain technology, right, or the ins and outs of it, but they know they're creatives, right? They can, right, make music or they can make art, and they know their sixth sense, spidey sense is tingling, and they know that something's going on and people are doing things different. What should they keep in mind as they concentrate on, you know, creating their content and doing their art?
Yeah, I think the big thing that, you know, I always harp on with artists is you have to sell your work, right? You have to sell the thing that you are getting good at. And, you know, traditionally, and even in the present day, you know, a lot of musicians, right, you know, they're giving their content away for free in order to sell t-shirts or hoodies or some sort of merch, right? And it doesn't really make a lot of sense, right? Because, you know, a musician is not a designer, a fashion designer, right? You know, McDonald's would never say, we want to make the best hamburger in the world and then give our hamburgers away to sell t-shirts, right? That's sort of the music industry right now. So, you know, when we talk to creatives and when I speak with them, you know, we really try to harp on this concept of getting people to buy something, right? And in all honesty, if it's selling t-shirts versus selling nothing, sell t-shirts. But ideally, you'd be selling your music, you'd be selling your paintings, you'd be selling your, you know, your writing, you'd be selling your production, right? And that's very important, because I think the market gives very important feedback to artists that they can then use to get better, and capital, right? And so besides, you know, the financial benefit, there's also the artist development benefit that comes from actually selling your work and, you know, being able to call yourself a professional by doing so. So we think the thing to maximize, you know, is not fans, it's transactions, right? You know, whatever you can sell. And you, you know, ideally, again, you're selling the thing that you are working to get better at. So that, you know, when we you know, think about the future for creatives in this, you know, creative economy that we're heading into, you know, the benefit of it is that, and crypto is a big part of it, but the benefit of the creative economy is now you can make money by being a creative, right? You don't have to be a starving artist anymore. And not only are you supported by technology, but you're supported by, like I said, I think a shift in mindset as well, where, you know, fans want to be supporting their artists. And I think crypto, to me, does the best of balancing the, you know, the benefits to the artist, right? You know, they get capital and they get a customer, right, who they can identify, which is very important. And then the fan, you know, they get an asset, right? They get, you know, a crypto asset that if they think that this artist is going to be more popular tomorrow than they are today, then this asset that they're holding should grow in value, right? And it's much different than the experience that, you know, a fan can have on Spotify or SoundCloud, where you can identify artists early, but there's no really way to financially support them directly or benefit from doing that. Or in, you know, cases like Bandcamp or Patreon, which I think are amazing businesses, but same thing, you know, you are, there's a liability associated with, you know, the support that you're giving an artist through Patreon without getting, you know, the sort of benefit of this asset that can grow in value over time. So, so we think, yeah, you know, long story short, to answer your question directly, it's about really just selling, and transacting. And that's why we're here. You know, my background's, you know, I was on Wall Street for a large number of years, and that was my focus, was, you know, how do we monetize? How do we make money? That's the business of Wall Street. And so, you know, what we are trying to do really is bring that mindset and that expertise that we've grown to artists, because we know if there's any hole in an artist's repertoire, traditionally, it's, you know, the business and sort of financial acumen, and it's super important, especially in today's world.
Yeah, well, that's super awesome. So, you know, let's drop all the ways that people can get in contact with you, because you guys, the Float team, doing some amazing work, and it's very important for creatives. So what are the best ways for folks to catch on?
Yeah, the best way is just, you know, go to float.co, PHLOTE.co. And click join Float, submit your information, and we'll have, you know, we'll be in touch. We are, you know, very, very soon going to announce some initiatives that, you know, we're going to be activating, and, you know, to be included on all that news and all those updates, that's the best way. So just go to the website, Float, PHLOTE.co, and yeah, join Float, and submit your information, and yeah, we'll be in contact.
Awesome. Thank you, AJ, for making time, and you were an awesome guest on Rock the Block, and look forward to future collabs with you guys, man. Thank you.
Yeah, no, thank you. Good to catch up.
Always.
Okay. Hope you guys have a great Wednesday. But to lead us out, wow, I got a lot of sunlight behind me. To lead us out, we're going to play one more thing, which is just this clip. Spectacular MC. Sorry about that. We're going to play this small clip about augmented reality, which I really think is the missing link in all of this crypto art and talk about crypto. Is as long as crypto is limited to what's behind this screen, remember, your computer is not the internet, it's just your access point to the internet. So we can create different access points. You know, initially it's going to be glasses embedded. You know, like Google Glass was the first attempt. As, again, processors get faster, chips get smaller, that's inevitability. Like, why would you carry around a phone, you know, in your hand when you can, you know, you can be hands-free and you're totally connected to the online world all the time, all day. So, yeah, I think that's where we're going, you know. And it's harder for you to drop your glasses. I mean, you can break your glasses, but they're in your face. They're not in your pocket. They're not slipping out your hand. Your hand's free. You can actually live like a human in the world with VR and AR combined with metaverse technologies. Now we're into it. Now we're talking about the future. Right now, metaverse is the internet in 1997. I'll probably even go earlier than that. Well, let's say it's the internet in 1997. That's where it is now. Give it 20 years. Where will we be? The internet that we're on right now, it's going to be there. It's like it's going to be like SMS you know, text. It's going to be like a background technology. It's not going to be, we're not going to think about it. We're going to take it for granted. It's not special. It's not going to be a thing. So to call it, to lead us out, we're going to play Dope Tech and just take a look at some of the new technologies. Think about the possibilities. Think about where you can inject your ideas into it and be inspired. We are the future.
Starting to feel real major around here.
Can you imagine that? Yo, this would happen in the future without you doing anything or you know, any software. It'd just be what the world would look like when you put your glasses on. New possibilities for art. You know, new possibilities for just media in general. Like, again, everything we've been thinking about as far as media has been about flat screens, us looking through a window. What happens when that technology is actually, you know, ubiquitous? Like, it's just, you know, it's with us every day. We don't have to purposely open up a computer or turn on a phone. It's just always on. It is the default mode of humanity to be in AR, VR. I think that's where we're going. That's pretty cool. I mean, come on now. I don't know if you saw that Key and Peele episode where he had this old kind of grizzled army vet played by Peele. And he saw this 3D display of, you know, like the modern movies where they show the 3D display of, you know, where your target is. And he was fascinated by it. I think that's going to be all of us. Like, we're going to be like, you know, I just think the internet is old news, baby. It's old tech. It's old media at this point. Education. Oh my God. Like, the possibilities of AR and VR in education, I mean, it's insane. I mean, let's, you know, textbooks are a technology, but they're outdated in a very inefficient way to transmit information. They're still dope, but they're not the most, I mean, it's, I mean, it has, books have a lot of benefits, you know, don't require batteries, electricity, high resolution. I can go on and on, but it is a technology, and it
is scans the ground with some shader graph effects in Unity, but it's not cool enough. Let's throw in this native plugin so we can talk to it. Start roll.
Initializing roll protocol.
Now let's give it a brain with a little Node.js, Python, and AIML. Hello?
Hi there.
Shout out Predicate. Thank you.
Fluids are not required by computers.
But I want them to actually do stuff. So let's add a call to wit.ai for NLP and add the Mapbox SDK.
Show me New York City.
Loading map.
Now I know what you're thinking. But Matt, how am I supposed to watch No Neck Ed? All right, let's make another Node.js script that calls to the YouTube API and then use this PHP script to extract the hard link to the video.
I know this is French no neck to most people, but...
Loading YouTube video.
Seen or spoken their roads.
It's not that complicated, honestly. Most coding is just text.
It's perfect. Watch the rest.
I'm knowing where things are located. Don't get intimidated by coding. I mean, the possibilities are endless. Look at this. I mean, like, come on. Beyond screens, baby. Beyond screens. So that's it for today, guys. Going forward, we're going to be changing our format a little bit. Metaverse Mornings will be moving soon to Low Key Giants Twitch channel, and this page will mainly be live drawing tutorials, more education-based. So stay tuned for updates. Again, thank you for joining me today for Metaverse Mornings. I love you. You're beautiful. You're gorgeous. The sun is behind me at my back. Come on now. Let's get it today, baby. Let's get it. Have a great day, y'all.
Today on Awesome Sauce, we're going to talk about Emory Douglas, Minister of Culture. Emory Douglas, born May 24th, 1943, is an American graphic designer who worked as the Minister of Culture for the Black Panther Party from 1967 until the party disbanded in the 1980s. Emory Douglas became an influential force within the Black Panther Party. Douglas's images were printed in the newspaper, The Black Panther. His depictions of African Americans as revolutionary fighters instead of victims, and of pigs in place of police and politicians, made Douglas a hero to his community and a subject of an investigation by the United States government. After a while, it flashed to me that you have to draw in a way that even a child can understand in order to reach your broadest audience without losing the substance or insight of what is represented, Emory Douglas. In addition to the paper, Douglas also designed postcards, event flyers, and posters that were meant as recruitment tactics, as well as an additional method of spreading the BBP ideology and creating the impression that there was mass support for the cause. Douglas drew a lot of inspiration from third world struggles and used art as the primary method of propaganda and outreach. His graphics served to promote the party's ideologies, which were inspired by the rhetoric of revolutionary figures such as Malcolm X and Che Guevara. His images were often very graphic, meant to promote and empower Black resistance with the hope of starting a revolution to end institutionalized mistreatment of African Americans. Douglas is now retired, but does some freelance design work discussing topics such as Black-on-Black crime and the prison industrial complex. A lot of his current work features children. He feels he must continue to educate through his work.
Go.
couple six, 7/8, meet him at the gate, and 9/10, do what old kids. It's lost souls, travel effortless journeys to be lost souls. When you drift beyond reality, you're self-exposed against the walls of fantasia, you'll be stoned. I told you not to console, but them don't listen, they claim they don't know. Ignorance, bliss, foolish sheep, follow shepherd, slow the pits. Why would you even try to intervene or come in between what's not done or seen yet? And won't God respect, change your intellect, see the truth, step the crap, don't shallow ground. You want a piece of it?
Today on Awesome Sauce, we're going to talk about Lady B, the godmother of hip hop. Lady B's rise and longevity in hip-hop earned her the title as the godmother of hip-hop. She is one of the first DJs to play rap records on the radio outside of New York. Wendy Clark, better known by her stage name Lady B, is an American female rapper and radio DJ from Philadelphia. She's one of the earliest female rappers in hip-hop and one of the first hip-hop artists to record a single. Clark recorded her first single, To the Beat Y'all, on the Sugar Hill record label in 1979, one of the first hip-hop singles recorded. She's one of the first DJs to play rap records on the radio outside of New York, playing artists such as Will Smith and Soul Sonic Force at the start of their careers. In 1984, Lady B moved to Philadelphia's Power 99 FM and started the program The Street Beat, which blew the radio station's ratings through the roof. She ran this program until 1989. Lady B received numerous awards throughout her career. In 2002, she received the Philly Urban Legend Award, which acknowledges pioneers in rap music, the world-renowned Entertainment Role Model of Excellence Award, two Lifetime Achievement Awards, including the Douglas Jocko Henderson Award, and is also listed in Vibe Magazine's History of Hip Hop as maybe the most influential female in hip hop radio history.
One, two, what you gonna do? Two, three, four, open the door. 5, 6, pick up the sticks. 7, 8, meet him at the gate. And 9, 10, do it all again. 1, 2, what you gonna do? 3, 4, open the door. 7, 5, 6, pick up the sticks. 7, 8, meet him at the gate. And 9, 10, do it all again. 1, 2, what you gonna do? 3, 4, open the door. 5, 6, pick up the sticks. 7, 8, meet him at the gate. And 9, 10, do what I want to get. It's lost souls, travel effortless journeys to be lost souls. When you drift beyond reality, you're self-exposed against the walls of fantasia, you'll be stoned. I told you not to console, but them don't listen, they claim they don't know. Ignorance, bliss, foolish sheep, follow shepherd, slow the pits. Why would you even try to intervene or come in between what's not done or seen yet? And won't God respect, change your intellect, see the truth, step the crap, don't shallow ground. You want a piece of it?
You're trying to battle, son. You don't want this. You don't want none of this. Oh, okay. You gonna savage on me? Let's go.
Hey, what's good, Metaverse? This is Tahu. Today we're going to check out one-offs beyond provenance, speculative black features in the blockchain. So, let's go. What's going on? This is Tahu. I'm right here in the metaverse doing VR art tours. Make sure you join us every day between 8 and 9 Eastern time. Go to www.athearts.com for a direct link. As long as crypto is limited to what's behind this screen, remember your computer is not the internet, it's just your access point to the internet. So we can create different access points. Initially it's going to be glasses embedded, like Google Glass was the first attempt. New possibilities for art, new possibilities for just media in general. Like, again, everything we've been thinking about as far as media has been about flat screens, us looking through a window. What happens when that technology is actually, ubiquitous? Like, it's just, it's with us every day, always on. It is the default mode of humanity. That's pretty cool. The internet is old news, baby. It's old tech, it's old media at this point. I love you. You're beautiful. You're gorgeous. Come on now. Let's get it today, baby.
Talk about hyperlinks.
Oh yeah, baby.
No, baby.
Yeah,
and
baby.
Not just regular text, baby.
That's right.
It's text that takes you everywhere. Yeah.
California, we have our number one spot
for the week.
Okay, we're gonna get set up in a minute. I'm gonna crack open a magic of boxes, and we're gonna make some boxes.
You know,
yay!
We play the hits, nothing but.
Hooray!
Let's go. Hey.
Super Cali Magic sipping purple power potion. Super Cali Magic sipping purple power potion. Super Cali Magic sipping purple power potion. Super Cali Magic, 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 magic. Super Cali Magic sipping purple.
I'm doing some little social media promotion right now. So if you found this from my Facebook or social media posts, thank you. Welcome. Hey neighbor, thanks for tuning in to Awesome Sauce.
Did somebody say Awesome Sauce?
Hey cool cat, what you have there?
Oh, this is my smartphone. Smartphones for very smart people, you know.
Oh, is that so? What are you doing with it?
I'm just looking up some facts on rats.
Facts on rats?
Yes, facts on rats. Yeah, did you know rats' teeth never stop growing?
Wow. Okay, how did you use your smartphone to find that out?
Oh, I went to this website called www.factsonrats.com.
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 All right, that's pretty cool. Want to learn something else cool today?
Yeah, man.
One of the reasons they call your phone a smartphone is because not only can you make calls like a regular phone, but you can also access the World Wide Web.
The who, what, why?
The World Wide Web. It's the system that we use to connect to web pages and mobile apps using the internet, which is the name for the computer network all this information travels on.
Are you having a stroke? I understood nothing you said.
No, I'm not having a stroke, silly. It can all be very complicated, but we'll start slow. Well, web pages are built using HTML, which stands for Hypertext Markup Language.
Hyperloop Markup Language, got it. That's a weird name for a language. Is it, like French? Like, parlez-vous français?
No. Almost. It's the language. Okay. Let's get into it. So right now I'm working on a voxel collection called Philly Join Collectibles, along with, a media firm here in Philadelphia called Dope Loco. So my design assignment is to create relatable characters based on some of the personalities in Philadelphia. So first, of course, you're a Philadelphia Eagles fan. So I'm going to kind of switch between the different voxel characters I've been working on. Very distinctive, three fingers and a thumb. And so I have a few different versions, Eagles Man 2, you know, make sure we have diversity. Eagles Man 3s, there we go. Like ill-defined diversity, I don't want to label these. Some other objects I've been working on. We got our football, of course. We have our, you know, Poppy Store Poppy. I can't name him that. Call Mr. Lopez. Wink, wink. I ain't getting canceled, bruh. I got two versions of a soft pretzel. One is this, and one is this one, which is like more chunky. No. I got a preference between the two? Huh? Preference? Let's see. Then we have actually put some beats on while we're sitting here, so it's not all dry and whatnot. Actually sitting here with me all dry. Apologies. What shall we play? I say we play some J Dilla. Because I like him. And I won't get flagged for beats. Let's go. Here we go. Let's get it. Okay. So also have, let's see what's got.
then I'm working on historical playsets based on places around Philadelphia. Icons like the Art Museum. What else? We got the Uptown. Yeah, yeah. Maybe the Love. Okay, of course, we got the water ice. And the bang is out in different flavors. Yeah. So I'm trying to figure out what I want to do. I need a list of what I'm working on. So let's go back to Eagles Man 1. Well, this is my, where's my default template? Let me round out the hood a little bit. Okay. Get all this. I'm gonna bring this out just a tad bit to square out the hood. So, I should see like a block. The hoodie should be a block. Just build it up slow. Alright, let's build it up slow. Now we take blocks away. And I kind of like the block at the top. I like it blocky. May give it a little bit of something, something, something. Work this out. Oops, too much. Okay, then we want all of this the same color. We want the paints. Say the two main voxel type insurance would be crypto voxels, you know, and yeah, actually I'm gonna paint the size of these joints, bro. Let's keep it 100. Let's work, bro. I'm gonna do something dilly to that dowel. I'm just trying to get a uniform. It's all uniform. Then I can do some details. Routine. I don't know.
Attention, mission, command, coming in the dock, yo, I'm gonna land. I got a plan, looking for a planet advantage, but I think I like where I landed. The cops say I'm a booty bandit, but the people would never understand it. I'm the commander, Alexander, and my co-pilot is a panda. Whoa, looking for some dough and some credits, and some three titties going to spend it. Need a cash app, boom, I'll send it. I'm all synced up, don't regret it. Yeah, yeah, let's get it, let's get it. Let's finish this box up. Gotta add some more drinks to it. Should I make his sleeves a different color? Should I just leave him as I is? Leave him as he is. Let's see, let's see, let's see, let's see. Shade. Is there a palette? A peanut?
seconds.
Sixth sense, spidey sense is tingling, and they know that something's going on and people are doing things different. What should they keep in mind as they concentrate on, you know, creating their content and doing their art?
Yeah, I think the big thing that, you know, I always harp on with artists is you have to sell your work, right? You have to sell the thing that you are getting good at. And, you know, traditionally, and even in the present day, you know, a lot of musicians, right, you know, they're giving their content away for free in order to sell t-shirts or hoodies or some sort of merch, right? And it doesn't really make a lot of sense, right? Because, you know, a musician is not a designer, a fashion designer, right? You know, McDonald's would never say, we want to make the best hamburger in the world and then give our hamburgers away to sell t-shirts, right? That's sort of the music industry right now. So, you know, when we talk to creatives and when I speak with them, you know, we really try to harp on this concept of getting people to buy something. Right. And so in all honesty, if it's selling t-shirts versus selling nothing, sell t-shirts. But ideally, you'd be selling your music, you'd be selling your paintings, you'd be selling your, you know, your writing, you'd be selling your production. Right. And that's very important, because I think the market gives very important feedback to artists that they can then use to get better and capital. Right. And so, besides, you know, the financial benefit, there's also the artist development benefit that comes from actually selling your work and, you know, being able to call yourself a professional by doing so. So we think the thing to maximize, you know, is not fans, it's transactions, right? You know, whatever you can sell. And you know, ideally, again, you're selling the thing that you are working to get better at. So that, you know, when we you know, think about the future for creatives in this, you know, creative economy that we're heading into, you know, the benefit of it is that, and crypto is a big part of it, but the benefit of the creative economy is now you can make money by being a creative, right? You don't have to be a starving artist anymore. And not only are you supported by technology, but you're supported by, like I said, I think a shift in mindset as well. where you know, fans want to be supporting their artists. And I think crypto, to me, does the best of balancing the, you know, the benefits to the artist, right? You know, they get capital and they get a customer, right, who they can identify, which is very important. And then the fan, you know, they get an asset, right? They get, you know, a crypto asset that if they think that this artist is going to be more popular tomorrow than they are today, then this asset that they're holding should grow in value, right? And it's much different than the experience that, you know, a fan can have on Spotify or SoundCloud, where you can identify artists early, but there's no really way to financially support them directly or benefit from doing that. Or in, you know, cases like Bandcamp or Patreon, which I think are amazing businesses, but same thing, you know, there's a liability associated with, you know, the support that you're giving an artist through Patreon without getting, you know, the sort of benefit of this asset that can grow in value over time. So we think, yeah, you know, long story short, to answer your question directly, it's about really just selling, and transacting. And that's why we're here. You know, my background's, you know, I was on Wall Street for a large number of years, and that was my focus, was, you know, how do we monetize? How do we make money? That's the business of Wall Street. And so, you know, what we are trying to do really is bring that mindset and that expertise that we've grown to artists, because we know if there's any hole in an artist's repertoire, traditionally, it's, you know, the business and sort of financial acumen, and it's super important, especially in today's world.
Yeah, well, that's super awesome. So, you know, let's drop all the ways that people can get in contact with you, because you guys, the Float team, doing some amazing work, and it's very important for creatives. So what are the best ways for folks to catch on?
Yeah, the best way is just, you know, go to float.co, PHLOTE.co. And click join Float, submit your information, and we'll have, you know, we'll be in touch. We are, you know, very, very soon going to announce some initiatives that, you know, we're going to be activating, and, you know, to be included on all that news and all those updates, that's the best way. So just go to the website, Float, PHLOTE.co, and yeah, join Float, and submit your information, and yeah, we'll be in contact.
Awesome. Thank you, AJ, for making time, and you were an awesome guest on Rock the Block, and look forward to future collabs with you guys, man. Thank you.
Yeah, no, thank you. Good to catch up.
Always.
Okay. Hope you guys have a great Wednesday. But to lead us out, well, I got a lot of sunlight behind me. To lead us out, we're going to play one more thing, which is just this clip. Spectacular MC. Sorry about that. We're going to play this small clip about augmented reality, which I really think is the missing link in all of this crypto art and talk about crypto. Is as long as crypto is limited to what's behind this screen, remember, your computer is not the internet, it's just your access point to the internet. So we can create different access points. You know, initially it's going to be glasses embedded. You know, like Google Glass was the first attempt. As, again, processors get faster, chips get smaller, that's inevitability. Like, why would you carry around a phone, you know, in your hand when you can, you can be hands-free and you're totally connected to the online world all the time, all day. So, I think that's where we're going, you know. And it's harder for you to drop your glasses. I mean, you can break your glasses, but they're in your face. They're not in your pocket. They're not slipping out your hand. Your hand's free. You can actually live like a human in the world with VR and AR combined with metaverse technologies. Now we're into it. Now we're talking about the future. Right now, Metaverse is the internet in 1997. I'll probably even go earlier than that. Well, let's say it's the internet in 1997. That's where it is now. Give it 20 years. Where will we be? The internet that we're on right now, it's going to be there. It's like it's going to be like SMS or, you know, text. It's going to be like a background technology. It's not going to be, we're not going to think about it. We're going to take it for granted. It's not special. It's not going to be a thing. So to call it, to lead us out, we're going to play Dope Tech. And just take a look at some of the new technologies. Think about the possibilities. Think about where you can inject your ideas into it. And be inspired. We are the future.
Starting to feel real major around here.
Can you imagine that? Yo, this would happen in the future without you doing anything or you know, any software. It'd just be what the world looked like when you put your glasses on. New possibilities for art. You know, new possibilities for just media in general. Like, again, everything we've been thinking about as far as media has been about flat screens, us looking through a window. What happens when that technology is actually, you know, ubiquitous? Like, it's just, you know, it's with us every day. We don't have to purposely open up a computer or turn on a phone. It's just always on. It is the default mode of humanity to be in AR, VR. I think that's where we're going. That's pretty cool. I mean, come on now. I don't know if you saw that Key and Peele episode where he had this old kind of grizzled army vet played by Peele. And he saw this 3D display of, you know, like the modern movies where they show the 3D display of, you know, where your target is. And he was fascinated by it. I think that's going to be all of us. Like, we're going to be like, you know, I just think the internet is old news, baby. It's old tech. It's old media at this point. Education. Oh, my God. Like, the possibilities of AR and VR in education, I mean, it's insane. I mean, this, you know, textbooks are a technology, but they're outdated in a very inefficient way to transmit information. They're still dope, but they're not the most, books have a lot of benefits, you know, don't require batteries, electricity, high resolution, and go on and on, but it is a technology. And it
it's game the ground with some shader graph effects in Unity, but it's not cool enough. Let's throw in this native plugin so we can talk to it.
Start roll.
Initializing roll protocol.
Now let's give it a brain with a little Node.js, Python, and AIML. Hello?
Hi there.
Shout out Predicate. Thank you.
Fluids are not required by computers.
But I want them to actually do stuff. So let's add a call to wit.ai for NLP and add the Mapbox SDK.
Show me New York City.
Loading map.
Now I know what you're thinking. But Matt, how am I supposed to watch No Neck Ed? All right, let's make another Node.js script that calls to the YouTube API and then use this PHP script to extract the hard link to the video.
That was just French to most people, but...
Loading YouTube video.
Seen or spoken the road.
Not that complicated, honestly. Most coding is just text.
It's perfect. Watch the rest.
I'm knowing what where things are located. Don't get intimidated by coding. I mean, the possibilities are endless. Look at this. I mean, like, come on. Beyond screens, baby. Beyond screens. So that's it for today, guys. Going forward, we're going to be changing our format a little bit. Metaverse Mornings will be moving soon to Low Key Giants Twitch channel, and this page will mainly be live drawing tutorials, more education-based. So stay tuned for updates. Again, thank you for joining me today for Metaverse Mornings. I love you. You're beautiful. You're gorgeous. The sun is behind me at my back. Come on now. Let's get it today, baby. Let's get it. Have a great day, y'all.
Today on Awesome Sauce, we're going to talk about Emory Douglas, Minister of Culture. Emory Douglas, born May 24th, 1943. Is an American graphic designer who worked as the Minister of Culture for the Black Panther Party from 1967 until the party disbanded in the 1980s. Emory Douglas became an influential force within the Black Panther Party. Douglas's images were printed in the newspaper, The Black Panther. His depictions of African Americans as revolutionary fighters instead of victims and of pigs in place of police and politicians made Douglas a hero to his community and a subject of an investigation by the United States government. After a while, it flashed to me that you have to draw in a way that even a child can understand in order to reach your broadest audience without losing the substance or insight of what is represented, Emory Douglas. In addition to the paper, Douglas also designed postcards, event flyers, and posters that were meant as recruitment tactics, as well as an additional method of spreading the BBP ideology and creating the impression that there was mass support for the cause. Douglas drew a lot of inspiration from third world struggles and used art as the primary method of propaganda and outreach. His graphics served to promote the party's ideologies, which were inspired by the rhetoric of revolutionary figures such as Malcolm X and Che Guevara. His images were often very graphic, meant to promote and empower Black resistance with the hope of starting a revolution to end institutionalized mistreatment of African Americans. Douglas is now retired, but does some freelance design work discussing topics such as Black-on-Black crime and the prison industrial complex. A lot of his current work features children. He feels he must continue to educate through his work. Today on Awesome Sauce, we're going to talk about Lady B, the godmother of hip-hop. Lady B's rise and longevity in hip-hop earned her the title as the godmother of hip-hop. She is one of the first DJs to play rap records on the radio outside of New York. Wendy Clark, better known by her stage name Lady B, is an American female rapper and radio DJ from Philadelphia. She's one of the earliest female rappers in hip-hop and one of the first hip-hop artists to record a single. Clark recorded her first single, To the Beat Y'all, on the Sugar Hill record label in 1979, one of the first hip-hop singles recorded. She's one of the first DJs to play rap records on the radio outside of New York, playing artists such as Will Smith and Soul Sonic Force at the start of their careers. In 1984, Lady B moved to Philadelphia's Power 99 FM and started the program The Street Beat, which blew the radio station's ratings through the roof. She ran this program until 1989. Lady B received numerous awards throughout her career. In 2002, she received the Philly Urban Legend Award, which acknowledges pioneers in rap music, the world-renowned Entertainment Role Model of Excellence Award, two Lifetime Achievement Awards, including the Douglas Jocko Henderson Award, and is also listed in Vibe Magazine's History of Hip Hop as maybe the most influential female in hip hop radio history.
One, two, what you gonna do? Two, three, four, open the door. 5, 6, pick up the sticks. 7, 8, meet him at the gate. And 9, 10, do it all again. 1, 2, what you gonna do? 3, 4, open the door. 7, 5, 6, pick up the sticks. 7, 8, meet him at the gate. And 9, 10, do it all again. 1, 2, what you gonna do? 3, 4, open the door. 5, 6, pick up the sticks. 7, 8, meet him at the gate. And 9, 10, do it all again. It's lost souls travel effortless journeys to be lost souls. When you drift beyond reality, you're self-exposed. Against the walls of fantasia, you'll be stoned. I told you not to console, but them don't listen. They claim they don't know. Ignorance, bliss, foolish sheep, follow shepherd, slow the pits. Why would you even try to intervene or come in between what's not done or seen yet? And won't God respect, change your intellect, sing the truth, step the crap, don't shallow ground. You want a piece of it?
You're trying to battle, son. You don't want this. You don't want none of this. Oh, okay. You gonna savage on me? Let's go.
Thank you.
Hey, what's good, Metaverse? This is Tahu. Today we're going to check out One Off Beyond Provenance, speculative black futures in a blockchain. So, let's go. What's going on? This is Tahu. I'm right here in the metaverse doing VR art tours. Make sure you join us every day between 8 and 9 Eastern time. Go to www.athearts.com for a direct link. As long as crypto is limited to what's behind this screen, remember your computer is not the internet. It's just your access point to the internet. So we can create different access points. Initially it's going to be glasses embedded, like Google Glass was the first attempt. New possibilities for art. New possibilities for just media in general. Like again, everything we've been thinking about as far as media has been about flat screens, us looking through a window. What happens when that technology is actually, ubiquitous? Like it's just, it's with us every day, always on. It is the default mode of humanity. That's pretty cool. The internet is old news, baby. It's old tech, it's old media at this point. I love you. You're beautiful. You're gorgeous. Come on now. Let's get it today, baby.
Talk about hyperlinks.
Oh yeah, baby.
No, baby.
Yeah,
and not just regular text, baby.
Okay.
It's text that takes you.
Let's make another box.
Everywhere.
Okay.
Yeah.
Warm a coffee up. Let it get cold. Then we're gonna make another box.
Welcome, sunny California. We have our number one spot for the week. In consecutive weeks, we have John Block with Super Cali. know we play the hits, nothing but the hits. Let's go. Hey.
Super Cali Magic sipping purple power potion. Super Cali Magic sipping purple power potion. Super Cali Magic sipping purple power potion. Super Cali Magic, 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 magic. Super Cali Magic sipping purple power potion.
Hey neighbor, thanks for tuning in to Awesome Sauce.
Did somebody say Awesome Sauce?
Hey cool cat, what you have there?
Oh, this is my smartphone. Smartphones for very smart people, you know.
Oh, is that so? What are you doing with it?
I'm just looking up some facts on rats.
Facts on rats?
Yes, facts on rats. Yeah, did you know rats' teeth never stop growing?
Wow. Okay, how did you use your smartphone to find that out?
Oh, I went to this website called www.factsonrats.com.
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 All right, that's pretty cool. Want to learn something else cool today?
Yeah, man.
One of the reasons they call your phone a smartphone is because not only can you make calls like a regular phone, but you can also access the World Wide Web.
The who, what, why?
The World Wide Web. It's the system that we use to connect to web pages and mobile apps using the internet, which is the name for the computer network all this information travels on.
Are you having a stroke? I understood nothing you said.
No, I'm not having a stroke, silly. It can all be very complicated, but we'll start slow. Well, web pages are built using HTML, which stands for Hypertext Markup Language.
Hyperloop Makeup Landings, got it. That's a weird name for a language. Is it, like French? Like, parlez-vous français?
No. Almost. It's the language the World Wide Web understands. So, here we go. I have some friends that can help us understand a little bit better. So, just stay tuned.
Okay. Go back to Magic of Voxels. Had an idea while I took my walk. I'll make a few more guys. Actually, I'm going to go back to my base human. Okay, and I want to make a duplicate. And where my beats at? My beats at. Think about making a Rasta. I think next I'm looking at the Uptown Theater mock up. I'll bring a picture. But I'm gonna stick here first. The beard for now. Actually, let's connect the beard, honestly. Make the hair a little bit blue. Let's try that. Actually, let's do that. Yeah. I know you like that. Alright, so what would we do? Are we going to paint on some blocks? How would we start these blocks? Ooh, I get beat up for that. Okay. Oops, I don't want to paint. I want to attach. Okay. Get us some baby dreads going here. Okay. What's this joint called? This is a. What's the band? Who's this? Guys, tell me. Oh, man. in that long dress, huh? Somebody in my gather space, my virtual office. Yeah, I know this shit. Oh man, it's on the tip of my tongue. He remembers it. Okay, alright, so. Like I said, it's a really easy tool to use. Like you follow along, you attach erase paint, then you have per block, per face, and you have like a little line tool. Yo, there's tutorials online. This is not what I'm doing today. Should I knock the ear back some? Or just have like the locks go through it? Yeah. Pretty relaxing and fun. Yeah. It's actually very fun. I always like playing the Legos. So this really makes my day. And I can make money doing it, so even better. Okay, let's other baby dreads, baby locks. There we go. Now we can start building up back here. Oops. Oh no. Chaos and catastrophe. What about this paint? I gotta build out these locks. Got a plane going here, so I gotta complete it. Again, working in magical boxes. Thank you.
how you making out today? We're making custom wearables and collectibles, NFTs, and magical boxes today. That is what's on the menu. If you want to know, now you know, now you know. Oops. Bring that lock all the way down. Oops. What about an even? Locks are even. And now I gotta do it cause I'm like you, and now the third I reflect eternally. I do it cause I burn you. You see? Alright, we'll come back to Kingston in the morning. Let's rock out. Thank you.
Platform really built for independent artists, powered by crypto. Maybe that's the easiest way to think about it. You know, we care about a couple things. We care about independent artists, especially recording artists, who we know have very little options for, you know, how to monetize their work in the current environment. And we think blockchain solves a lot of their problems. And we, you know, we know that this technology is not easy to understand, and it requires some onboarding. So, you know, our real system and our business, our platform that we're building does two things. It helps us identify talented artists that we want to help elevate and we want to, you know, help amplify. And then the second part is an accelerator that allows us to onboard these artists and to get them more familiar with crypto and how to use these tools to build sustainable careers for themselves.
Okay. So, some of the things that you described and the idea of, you know, kind of helping support artists, education, reaching their audience, and managing their career as a business. So it sounds like, does this work in tandem, you know, if an artist has an agent, you know, or is this like the new form of agency moving forward?
I think there's a lot of ways to for an artist to implement this into what they're already doing. You know, we think that for at least the time being, there is a, you know, parallel system that is sort of put in place. And the artists have their, you know, their traditional music business, right? That includes, you know, Spotify and SoundCloud and Apple Music. They may be, you know, signed. They may have agent, they may have manager, etc., that infrastructure. What they probably don't have is someone who is very formidable on the tech side, right? And I think we think that that's a very important part of the infrastructure that every artist needs. And so whether you, you know, have all the other pieces, you know, this is a piece that's going to be required and can, you know, be integrated into everything else an artist does.
Oh, very cool. All right. And so that integration, is that thing simply like, you know, like an app, you know, in a sense where, you know, I can get stats and data and information? Is it a real-time agent waiting there to tweet with me and to message? How does that work?
Yeah, we'll see. I think, you know, what we are really doing is we're going to build right alongside the community. So we have an idea and a vision for what the initial product looks like. But over time, it's going to evolve a lot, right? You know, just given what...
Let's get back into it. Taking our Rasta character in Magical Boxes right now. Thank you for joining my little work stream, keeping me company. Appreciate you. House. Oh no, oh no. Is he a killer? Is he a lover? I don't understand, it's another type of something that I can't put my finger on. If I miss, man, he gonna write the thing along. Sometimes I wanna sing along. Sometimes I take that thing and I bring it along. Just in case cats wanna go ahead and ring me along. Don't cause no trouble, won't cause no harm. Yeah. Got the world right into my palm. 33rd Psalms. I'm the bomb. Wanna get it in, you wanna get it on. You better fall back while I'm on the attack. See us here. You almost there. Just build out the blocks. You're gonna hear some texture here. Alright, yep. Here we go. Okay, make it uneven. There we go. Oops. Nope. Let's pull back a little bit. Let's see what we got. Yeah. Looking spiffy. Even spring come down a little bit. Let's see how that looks. Oops.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. We're almost there.
Turn it up. Turn it up.
More blocks. It's like building Legos. And actually, Magical Voxel has this dope feature. The turn the block textures into Legos. Let's go to render. I think we can do it there. Okay, we're gonna call this Eagles Man 4. Where's the Lego? Metal, glass, cloud, blend. All. How do we see all? There's like a Lego.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know if they have to Google it. I thought it was right here. Emit blend. But there's like, maybe hit all ears, ones. That was scary. Turn. Okay. All right, we'll come back to that. But you can make these blocks in a Lego block, which is cool. I'm trying to figure out, let's build this out here. Zoom this in. I don't want to be even on both sides. I want a little bit uneven. Let's take a look underneath. Let's kind of build out some of these here.
do another one. There we go. Get a nice long box. Some room right here. Okay. One more spot right here. We can do some with. Just fill in those gaps. There. Okay. I think it's looking good. I don't want to overdo it. Disconnect his beard. There we go. Okay. Now let's give him a different fit. Let's vary him a little bit. Let's change up his clothes a little bit. Let's save another version. Let's duplicate this. Let's change this. Change up his clothes, colors a little bit. Brighter outfit maybe. No, not that. Blues. Like that. Give him some red shoes. Give him red kicks. Yeah. Like that. Okay. Let's paint the faces. Give him some shoelaces. Rename all these guys. That was fun. Give him another outfit. Let's duplicate again up here on the right. Let's bring it down some. Mistake. Smell a little bit.
fix his neck. Back to paint. Some women, so maybe I'll use this as my base. Yeah, so my women model. So first, we're gonna get rid of the beard, right?
Thank you.
paint the hair in here some. Set a touch. There we go. Filling these spaces here. Okay. Yeah. Black there, there we go. Kind of makes the face. Kind of calm down. Maybe I can add a chin. A chin, maybe? Let's see how that looks. Maybe a poopy. Okay, it's the nose. I think what it is like, I think I can release this. Oops. This. Bring the hair down. There we go. Attach the hair. There we go. Fill in some of this dead space. Thank you.
plus.
It says free to download. Super easy. Super easy. Yeah, yeah. Switch back over to my normal puppets. I want to scare you guys. Hey, hey. All right, we're rocking today. What time is it? Let me check my Slack. See how I gotta get back. Word. Back in the gather for a minute and close up magical boxes. I think made a few good ones and come back. We're gonna make try to make a playset, like the structure. I could do something different with her hair, but I kind of like it. It's like a little bun. I like that. It's kind of slick. Okay. All right. So stay tuned, we shall return.
See yourself exposed against the walls of fabrication. You're the stone. I told you not to console, but them don't listen, they claim they don't know. And ignorance, bliss, foolish sheep, follow shepherd, slow the pits. Why would you even try to intervene or come in between what's not done or seen yet? And won't God respect, change your intellect, see the truth. Step the crap on shallow ground. You want a piece of it?
You're trying to battle, son. You're trying to battle, son. You don't want this. You don't want this, son. You don't want none of this. Oh, okay. You gonna savage on me? You gonna savage on me?